Hi, my name is Matthew Rocknich. I am a developer evangelist here at DocuSign. I'm here today with Steve-O Parish, who is a lead software developer. Steve-O, thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you for having me.
So Steve-O, how did you get your start in software engineering?
I started here at DocuSign, actually. When I was about 20, like pretty much out of high school, I started here working as like a web developer, then an Android and iOS developer, and sort of transitioned to leading our signing product.
So did you have that classic dropout story, or how did it all work?
Not quite. Like, I sort of did a mix. Like, I like did part-time for a while, and then ended up taking more of a full-time role here, and then now I'm actually just finishing up completely now.
That's so cool.
Yeah, yeah.
So having been here for so long, what's your favorite part about DocuSign?
My favorite part is the people I get to work with, first and foremost. And then I think secondary, like, I've gotten to see a lot of use cases become real here. So I've got to see like use cases become live in like customer environments and see how they use the product, and it's been pretty exciting.
That's so cool.
Yeah.
What's your current area of focus?
Current area of focus, for the last 9 months, we've been working on a new product that I'm really excited to show you guys today. It's called DocuSign Click.
Great. Let's jump in on that. DocuSign Click, very exciting new product. What exactly is it?
Yeah, DocuSign Click is a clickwrap solution that's easy to use, simple to deploy. It helps you capture customer consent of like standard terms while lowering your costs and improving the customer experience.
Great. And from my understanding, there's a Click API as well. How does the Click API differ from our existing e-signature API?
It differs in that Click doesn't use a lot of the advanced features you'd expect out of the e-signature API, and that you can't use form fields, signatures, and like any of their other advanced features. Instead, Click agreements are simply uploaded. You specify a few parameters, and DocuSign wraps this into an iframe that you can embed within your own websites and apps. This concept is known as a Clickwrap, and it only takes a few minutes to implement.
Incredible. Can you show us how to actually use a Clickwrap live?
Absolutely.
Let's do it.
So I'm on the usual manage page you're used to seeing, except for there's also a tab for Clickwraps now. So if you were jumping in here, we have basically the high level of what your agreements and their versions are. So you can see like V1, V2, if you've incremented versions and required users to reaccept. So I'll go ahead and create a new one. And this is the name that's internal. So your users won't see this name, but your, I guess, management team would. So I'm going to go ahead and upload a new PDF of agreement. And this gets turned into HTML and basically makes a responsive version of the document you upload. And then you'll see it here in the preview on the left. I'll go ahead and set this as the title for our users. And then I can switch through the format. So modal being it will show over your entire web page, or inline being it shows like within a web form, like if you have it at the end of a complete form. So and then control, you can add a checkbox sort of to prevent them from finishing before they agree. Require them to read the document
to
as well.
Actually read the document, yeah.
You can also allow them to download a copy at the end.
Gotcha.
So I'm going to go ahead and create this version. And then after that, you can go ahead and hit the get code button, copy the code inside the modal, and bring it over to our implementation stage. So we have sort of a test bed here to try and show off like different click wraps. So this is one that I have implemented. And I'm pointing to my demo environment with that, and then our current account where we have the Clickwrap on, and the Clickwrap I may have just created. But those parts are pretty fixed for your Clickwrap you implement. But the client user ID is really a unique ID that you have pointing to your user. So that's how we determine if a user has previously signed or not. So in this case, I'm going to go ahead and provide it with something I know is unique. Then you can also provide at the end of the agreement any sort of callbacks of like when you know they have to agree, when the agreement's completed, or if any errors happen during the agreement.
Got it.
So we're going to go ahead and set a quick handler for when the agreement completes successfully. And then I'm going to go ahead and run my Clickwrap. So as soon as I do this, it's going to call this Clickwrap render. And it's going to show over my page and require this person to run. Sign. So it's pretty quick. I have to read it first.
You have to read it before you can sign it. Excellent.
Yes, yes. As we said before. And then I will go ahead and check the box and agree. And you'll see actually the code that I had set up in
callback.
It's a callback.
Excellent.
So I'll click OK, and my agreement's completed.
Very cool. Very excited to see what our developers can do with our Click and Click API and the Click wraps. If you are ready to get started using Click, head over to developers.docusign.com. We have documentation, getting started guides, et cetera, on there. But otherwise, Steven, thank you so much for being on the show today.
Thank you for having me, Matt.
Have a good one.
Thanks.
Hi, thank you so much for watching the video. If you'd like to learn the latest and greatest in DocuSign technology, I would highly encourage you to attend our Momentum conference and hackathon in June in San Francisco. It's completely free for developers.